Thanks for joining us for another Press Row Hangout Short. This time around, we're going to briefly discuss the first news related to NBA 2K16. Now, this is a game that doesn't come out until early October, so there's nothing officially announced yet. But we do have some info related to the apparent involvement of a big name from the entertainment world. We've known since last month that Spike Lee had some involvement with NBA 2K16. He was said to be in town working on the game. Now, thanks to a report from Polygon, it's realized he's playing a bigger role in its development than just being involved in the marketing campaign, which is something he's been a part of in the past with NBA 2K10. Spike Lee wouldn't be the first name from entertainment to have influence on the NBA 2K series. Jay-Z was the executive producer of NBA 2K13. So what does Spike Lee mean for NBA 2K16? It's clear he's directly involved with the story mode known as My Career, which was also introduced 3 years ago. So what does this news mean to you, Rich, if anything? I mean, clearly we're going to be speculating here. We don't know anything necessarily about it, but I think it's fair to presume a few things about the game by having this knowledge. And I'm curious what comes to mind first for you.
Well, I love it. I mean, it's terrific news. Spike Lee is a professional screenwriter. He is a storyteller. He is a huge NBA fan. I mean, I'm not going to sit here and say I'm a huge Spike Lee fan. I mean, I've seen a couple of his movies, and I'm certainly aware of his exploits over the years. But, you know, whether you like his work, love it, or don't, he's a guy who I think is in terrific position to dramatically contribute to the game. And as you know, Brian, I love NBA 2K as a franchise, 14 right now. I mean, 14 and 15 on next-gen consoles. We've had dozens of hours of conversations about it. So I'm a fan of the current story. If the current story was the actual story improved dramatically, that's nothing but great news. There are some potential risks, which I'm sure we'll get into as well. But off the bat, it sounds fantastic. I can wait. But I'm excited to see what they got cooking.
Yeah, so a little background. My career mode in NBA 2K, if you haven't played it, it's basically a story mode where you're playing as an individual player. Usually you're creating yourself or someone that you represents something for you, and you're playing through a story, things that happen off the court in addition to what you play on it. And so in the past couple of years, they've had this story element to the career mode. And for the most part, people have really, really gotten into it. But there have been a downside to it is that it's very scripted. And some people like to have a little more freedom or see more choices. And then just the kind of corny nature of the stories that they've come up with. And really poor dialogue, really bad voice acting. I mean, it's a fun mode, but it has those issues. So when I hear Spike Lee, the first thing that I think of is maybe this is going to be grittier, which I think would be welcome for me at least. If you look at movies of Spike's in the past, like He Got Game, now they're probably not going to go R-rated, which actually EA Sports did with their story mode in Fight Night Champion. It was the first M-rated sports game, or licensed sports game at least, and from EA. And but I do think that it could mean something different for the story, in that maybe it's going to be a little more serious. Maybe it's going to, maybe it goes something along the lines of a He Got Game type story, where you're working your way up and you're dealing with all this stuff off the court that isn't necessarily glamorous. And but then you're also being tempted by various things. They've tried to work in elements of those into the stories already, but again, a lot of them fall flat and they're laughable. So what do you think, Rich? Do you think Spike Lee, because I do feel they're involving him more than just being a name on there. I think he probably has some input on the actual story and where it goes. So do you feel the same as me in that regard? And do you think that would be a good change for the mode?
Well, it's very interesting because the NBA 2K career mode, it is a story mode, and it is schmaltzy and sort of silly, but it's sort of on purpose, and I think that kind of contributes to the charm of it. But its biggest challenge is that it's trying to tell a story over the course of multiple 82-game seasons when you play all or at least some of those games. So its biggest challenge is trying to figure out how to tell a story over such a long period of time when a significant number of people won't get to the middle or the end of it. So I wonder, too, if the story mode doesn't somehow become almost something entirely different, where it just may incorporate mini games or some sort of basketball, but not spread out over the course of actually being a player playing every game, or, you know, playing 82 game seasons. I mean, for 8, 10, 15 years, as long as it takes to play an entire NBA career, that's a shocking amount of time to have to invest in something. So I think that's also, that's what I'm thinking about, and I think it may go in that direction.
You're probably right. And Fight Night Champion did that. They had certain, like, really unique challenges you'd have to face in each match that added to the story. And now I think in My Career Mode, a lot of people, there's the option to sim through and just play really the important games.
Right.
And so if they did something different with those games and shorten the experience so that you do progress farther into it, I think that's a good idea. So the first year with this story mode in 2K14, it was you started in the first round.
Mm-hmm.
You were drafted in the first round, but you were drafted behind a rival of yours, and then you kind of went at him through your career. And then
Jackson Ellis.
And he even appears in 2K15's career mode in a different role. Yep. But in that one, you were an undrafted free agent. So they do have to come up, as far as the story mode goes, they have to come up with different angles every year. So I think that's a big challenge, and they're probably leaning on someone like Spike Lee to come up with something different here.
Absolutely, yeah. And that's when I also start to think, you know, maybe they don't keep it the same, right? I mean, maybe it does change because, I mean, if I'm running that game, that's one of the things I'm thinking is, wow, we got to come up with a new one every single year and spend the time not only in that, but also in making sure that the game itself on the court is good. I mean, I'd be willing for a year, right, to give up playing hundreds of games as an individual player for a 3, 4, 5 hour compelling story with basketball in it, as long as the rest of the NBA game, which I love so much, also continues to be around it. It would be very interesting, right? Because some people would probably get into a bit of an uproar, like, wait a second, now I can't play all these games. I got this thing. But, you know, on the other hand, it would be a bold experiment. And, you know, I think that there would be a larger appeal to a larger number of people if they knew they could buy this game and play this mode and wouldn't have to become good at basketball, but could still have fun doing it.
That's true. I mean, there are a lot of NBA fans, I think, who would pick up the game and feel overwhelmed by it. And its accessibility and the difficulty has always been an issue for really all of the league licensed sports games. So that's an interesting challenge for them to try and overcome, and they have to do different unique things. And unfortunately, we also have to look at if they're going to introduce something different, how is it going to work with their kind of the microtransaction culture now of digital revenue? Because the reason why My Career has worked out so well for them is because people want to invest in their player. People know they're going to stick with that player for months playing the game, and so they're willing to spend money in those modes. And if they were to reduce it to something smaller, then it might be more difficult to get money out of those people, unfortunately.
Yes, that's 100% right, which would be a compelling reason for them not to change the structure of having a story sitting on top of playing 82 games a year every year plus the playoffs. But on the other hand, I could first, you know, and I don't have any quantitative analysis to do it, but I could also say, well, you know, we make a lot of money in my team, and we make a lot of money on the guys buying their stuff for themselves in the park, that maybe if we're able to attract another 15 or 20% of people because their buddies tell them, dude, you can play this game without having to learn how to play NBA 2K. You can play this really fun Spike Lee movie.
Yeah.
You know, because these are powerful consoles with powerful, powerful abilities. Maybe that bump in people that buy it opens up more doors to people who would then spend money on the other modes. I don't know. I mean, I'm not going to be cynical and say that they're purposefully going to somehow find a way to monetize it even more, but I'm also not going to be naive in that that's not a consideration, because obviously the post-sale revenue that they generate is a huge reason that they're able to do big things like this in the first place.
And another thing that comes to mind for me is, what if there's a street ball angle here? Because we're talking New York culture, Spike Lee, and then also the shift towards a lot of street ball type modes with the My Park mode, where you join up as you take your My Player who stars in your My Career. It's probably confusing anybody who hasn't played, because all these different levels and modes. But you take them onto the court and you join up with other people and play against them there. So I wouldn't be surprised also if there was some sort of street ball culture angle to the story this year. That just came to mind right now. And who knows? I'll probably be wrong, but we're just taking guesses here now.
That's right. Well, the good thing is NBA 2K15 is still fantastic. And it's in my PlayStation 4 right now. So I'm continuing to have fun playing with that. I'm playing in the NBA Finals right now in my first season of my GM, which has been an absolute blast. I'm still playing the story in my player as well. So that's the best part about this is, yeah, it's fun always to talk about the future. But right now there's a heck of a basketball game that got a whole lot of life in it. You know, we got the start of the NBA playoffs. So now is a great time to also be playing that, because I sure am.
Yeah, and we're nearing that time of the year where 2K Sports starts to reveal a few things about the game. Generally, it's the cover, and it's accompanied by a little bit of information. And that typically comes out around NBA Finals time or during the NBA Finals. So we're, with how long the NBA playoffs stretch on for like 6 months. So maybe we're not
finals, the finals are in June.
Yeah, okay, June. But they stretch on for like 6 months, it feels like. So we're right
basketball,
there.
That's a good thing, right?
Yeah. So we're right there. It's right around the corner. We'll find out, this will be confirmed, and then they'll explain his role in the game, and we'll get a better understanding of what it's going to mean, and then we'll have to talk about that again, and then, cover athletes, and it sounds like it's going to be Steph Curry on one cover, James Harden on another cover, and Kevin Durant on a third cover, according to the information. So that'll probably be confirmed also in the coming weeks. So we'll be back to talk about all that stuff and more in future Press Row Hangout shorts. So thanks, everyone. See you then.